Jose has been working at the Furukawa Plantation Company since 1999. He lives in a single room with his family and one of the company's plantations. He says bad workers' conditions have caused serious injuries among the employees, and he complains that the company has never fulfilled its obligations.
Everyone wants to leave. I want to leave too. Recently, I heard that Furukawa is going to fix the camps and they will give us $500 a month. No one will accept that. We are already in terrible conditions.
Walter is one of those helping the Furukawa employees. He says they just want the workers' right to be respected.
The company is now closed. It would very bad if opens again in 2 months and the workers have to go back to the same thing. And at this point, the state should have a plan for the workers.
Various organizations in defense of human and workers' rights are also supporting the employees.
If the state does nothing to punish the company, if it doesn't insist that the company pays them what they are legally entitled to and pays for the abuses it has committed, then the state will be an accomplice to the systematic violation of human rights at Furukawa Company.
The owner of Furukawa argues that the company has turned Ecuador into the world's second biggest exporter of avocado fiber, and that it has met all its commercial tax and labor obligations. However, the workers are warning of new violations of their rights.
We know that Furukawa is planning to destroy the workers' camps and leave them on the streets. These people already live in miserable condition and they have nowhere to go apart from these camps.
Our rights must be respected. There are children and teenagers who have been raped in the camp. My daughter was raped, and they don't understand. I will not allow this as long as I live.
The workers say they want talks at the highest level to find a peaceful solution. They also accuse the government of protecting the company's interests while it abuses its workers' rights. Denise Herrera, Telesur, Ecuador.